I just got these new tires mounted and balanced. They're all cleaned up and detailed and real pretty. I removed the glue from the old weights. And anyways, I was just curious. I just wanted to check to confirm that the balance was good. So take a look. So I learned that the balance isn't good. I have my own wheel weights. Ta-da! And I learned that it took 3 of those quarter ounce wheel weights to balance it. Now I took them off because I'm gonna bring it back in tomorrow and Steven's gonna take a look at it at CycleWise and rebalance it for me. And then there's one other issue. On the front wheel, oh, there it is. Hang on. Listen. I don't know if you can hear it, but there's something rolling around inside. Steven thinks it's probably a piece of his mounting machine or his tire machine. It's a little plastic clips that protect the rim. He thinks a piece broke off and got inside the wheel. That's problematic because if something's loose inside, it'll throw the wheel balance off as well. So the back one needs to be rebalanced. Front one needs to be torn down, cleaned out of whatever's inside, and then rebalanced again, remounted and rebalanced again. So I'm doing that tomorrow morning. He got me in real quick, and another trip to beautiful Middlebury, Vermont. Oh, and by the way, I'm a little worried because that jacket is there, the Alpine Star. I promised my wife I wouldn't see her again. Good morning. It is 8 o'clock in the morning and I am heading back to CycleWise, north of Middlebury. I think it's called New Haven, Vermont. All right. All right, but hey, at least the Cadillac is nice and clean. Look at that. I washed it. We still have feet of snow around us here. Now, once you leave Woodstock, there's not much snow at all. Everyone around me is posting riding pics. It's an early spring, actually. Very early. A little bit of a 3-hour round trip. So I gotta admit, I'm very tempted to buy something like a Nomar tire installer, you know, for motorcycles. Some kind of a home quality use. Because if mounting and balancing your wheels, when you bring them in person and you pay $85 to have that done, that adds up, right? Over the lifetime of riding. Plus, there's the satisfaction of doing it yourself. It's very therapeutic. It's very peaceful and rewarding. DIY. I didn't mean to set out to make that my thing. It's just what I do, it's just what I like. So tools, process, approach, all of it. How do you do it? Figure it out, get it done. Doesn't mean I know more than anyone else. Doesn't mean I know more than the professional mechanic. It just means I'm willing to try, and I'm willing to learn, and I fail, and I learn through failure. All right, so now we are leaving the big city of Middlebury and heading towards New Haven, Vermont. CycleWise! Not only do they have the most awesome jacket here, they have my new helmet, the RF 1400 in a medium. I have a large, but I want to try the medium on. These guys know me. They know me. All right, Steven bumped the weights over on the back a little bit and cleaned out the front tire. He said it was dead nuts. All right, so I'm gonna boogie back home and I'm gonna get started, hopefully this weekend, reassembling my entire bike. I still got it pretty tore down. Gotta get the wheels, fenders, chain adjusted, put the brakes back on, tighten up those front forks, and I'm out of here. Oh, I'm so thankful to have that taken care of. So I just got home and I'm checking balance just because I was curious. I like to make sure it's balanced, and it's not balanced. I checked, this is perfectly level, but we're not balanced. So I'm gonna remove the weights and just start from scratch, balance it myself, and should be good to go. You know, sometimes I've seen this happen when I used to balance wheels on cars, is you'd use the machine and you would put the weight where it says to put the weight. And if you just stopped right there and just assumed it was good, then this is what would happen. You weren't really perfectly balanced. But if you spun it again, sometimes it would show you it needed a little more weight or the position changed a little bit. So you always got to spin after you weight to make sure it actually balanced. And that might be the step that's missing because we're not balanced. Old weights have been removed. New weights going on. Last time it took 3, so I'm gonna start with 3. Hopefully I don't have to remove one. I just won't push them on real hard at first. All right, testing. Whoa. I put the weight double stacked. I won't leave it like that, but I was curious. It needs denser weight right here, so I'll probably put it right behind it. But I think I found the spot. So his weights were here. My weights are here. I think, I'm guessing right now, based on this, the weight was too spread out. It was the right amount of weight, but it needed to be focused more in a stack in a smaller area. Because with them like this, it balanced out. Oh, that's really good. So I think ultimately this was the difference. It used 4 quarter-ounce weights. And I think he used 4 quarter-ounce weights, but his were all in a line and it spread the weight out too much. It needed to be narrower. And with it narrower, we're now in good shape. All right, now I need to check the front. The tireless pursuit of perfection. That one's pretty rock on. Look at that. A little bit. A little bit of movement. Not bad. I don't think it's significant enough. No, I think this one's good. That's brand new. Ow. I just detailed my rims and touched all of them up. That's all brand new scratching. Yikes. I'm definitely gonna get my own wheel tools. So, you know, would I have been able to feel that imbalance? Maybe not. Maybe it was close enough. But I do know this, as a person who used to mount tires, car tires, not motorcycle tires, that if it's a little bit off, you don't really feel it, but it wears the tire faster. So that little bit of offness, what is that worth? 1,000, 2,000 miles off the life of an 8,000 mile tire? If it's perfect, you'll get the best life from the tire. Heat, wear, everything. It just runs and works better. So I'm glad I checked. I'm thankful to the Lord I've got the tools to check. And again, that's all this is. I think these are like $20 and you put them on your jack stands. Make sure you're level and you're good to go. And you can do your own balancing. Buy your own box of weights. Cheap. So the one thing I'm missing now in my garage is an installer. And these T30s are excessively tight. I don't even know if the installer will get me there. All right, enough poor me. I'm gonna get to work. New brake lines, new brake fluid, new fork fluid, new tires, new rear spring arm lube. Man, this bike's been gone through. New radiator fluid, and I gotta still put in my new oil. Hey, you might have noticed I haven't tightened up the front axle completely yet, because it's the last thing you do for alignment's sake. You leave it kind of loose, it's a little snug, and then when you set it down on the ground, you kind of bounce up and down on it a little bit to align that front wheel with the forks. Then you tighten it down, then you put in your cinch bolts, the clamp bolts on the bottom of the fork. And I'll be using my medium threadlocker blue on those cinch bolts, cinch clamp bolts. You can feel side load. And if you feel side load, it's not aligned. So I just keep adjusting it until it's not pressing on one side of the gear or sprocket or the other, until it's perfectly centered. And you'll feel it and hear it. It'll get really quiet and super smooth. And you will feel it in your shifter and in your rolling and vibration. It'll be smooth. And that's what you want. So I'm catching up pretty quick here. I just gotta put the oil in. Boy, just a couple more things and I'll be done, ready to ride. It's starting to melt. It could happen by Easter day. Lord willing. I'm gonna die in the ice. That's the closest thing to a complete overhaul I've ever done on a motorcycle. Ooh, she's on the ground. Yeehaw, new tires too. Oh, it looks so pretty. It's so clean everywhere. Very nice. All right, front forks. Bounce up and down a couple of times, then tighten them. The bouncing up and down just kind of aligns the front wheel with the position of the forks. That's my understanding. So that's what I'm gonna do. So the manual says the standard height of these bolts should be 9 millimeters, sticking out 9 millimeters. Foot-pounds. Now I've got brand new cinch bolts. I talked about it in my first video when I broke free the one that froze inside this cinch clamp. They're precision, they feel so good. So what I'm gonna do is put a little blue medium thread locker, which is more like a wax and will repel water and dirt, which is what caused the other ones to actually freeze up. It wasn't corrosion, it was water and dirt. So I could use Permatex like I had, Permatex anti-seize as I had previously planned. However, it stays wet and it attracts dirt. I don't want that. So we're gonna go with thread locker and seal the threads from the elements. Now I'm doing it on the ends because these are a little bit longer than the other ones. I could cut them, but I don't feel like it. I'd have to machine the ends a little bit to round them. I actually bought a nut. You put the nut on and then cut it to length and then take the nut off. So it cleans the threads as you're taking the nut off, but I don't feel like it. So I'm just putting them in with thread locker on them. I'll probably add a little bit on the end that sticks out here, These are 40 millimeter instead of 35 millimeter. The forks definitely feel tighter than they did before. I might have to take a little fluid out. I don't think I'm gonna know until I take it for a little ride. All right, and these cinch bolts, like the other ones above, are 23 newton meters. I'm gonna use my brand new Naco Allens that fit so much better than my tired, worn out ones. 23. Unless I'm forgetting something, I think we're done. Winter Projects 2021 is complete. A lot of maintenance, a lot of updates, a lot of grease, a lot of tear down. So the question is, did I put the right amount of fork oil in my bike? They feel tighter. Might have to take some out. We'll find out and I'll let you know. But I'm gonna start this up, check my oil level, top it off if needed. And I think I'm ready for summer 2021 riding season. Thanks for watching. God bless you guys. Take care of yourselves. We'll catch you next video.